Let's write the balanced equation for Zn plus CuSO4. This is zinc metal plus copper 2 sulfate. We'll also look at the type of reaction, and then we'll write the states of matter. So let's count the atoms up and balance the equation. One zinc, one copper, and we're going to count the SO4 as one thing. That's a polyatomic ion. We have it over here as well. So when you have a polyatomic ion like the sulfate ion on both sides, it's really helpful to count it as one thing. You get the same answer either way. It's just a lot quicker. One sulfate. Product side, we have zinc, just one of those, one copper, and then our one sulfate. And you can see that this equation, it's already balanced. If you wanted to report the coefficients for the equation, they'd be 1, 1, 1, 1, but we don't write them by convention. The type of reaction here, we have zinc, and it's coming in and it's pushing the copper out. Now the copper's all by itself. So the zinc, this single zinc here, it's replaced the copper in CuSO4. That makes this a single displacement reaction. So the zinc has replaced the copper here in the copper sulfate. This would also be a redox reaction because oxidation states are changing on the zinc and copper. If you wanted to write the states, zinc, that's a metal. This copper is also a metal. Then we have aqueous copper 2 sulfate. This is a blue solution. And the zinc sulfate, that's also aqueous. It's clear. So you start out with a blue solution here with the copper 2 sulfate. You end up with a clear zinc sulfate solution and solid copper at the bottom of the beaker. This is Dr. B with the balanced reaction for Zn plus CuSO4. We also looked at the type of reaction, single displacement, and we put the states in. Thanks for watching.